In general, this is not the first intervention we've seen in the Ivory Coast and in a whole lot, a whole list of other countries in the region. And we might want to talk a little bit about Libya later. Go ahead.
Absolutely. I think the intervention by the West has always been their game plan. Usually, if they've got need for regime change or if there's more, something more pertinent in terms of resources, allocation or land grabbing. But nonetheless, I think in this particular instance, I think the French were very, very keen and eager to get into the gameplay. And I think it's a mistake because it sent the wrong signals that, especially when they supported Mr. Ouattara very heavily, that Mr. Ouattara's campaign and governance moving forward will be tainted to an extent by the fact that he is a supporter of the West. He is controlled and he will deal with the West far kindly than any other leader would otherwise do. But I think Mr. Gbagbo found himself in a lot of trouble going as far back as 2000 when he came into power, not to mention in 2002 when he refused to get Mr. Ouattara to engage in the political machine in that country. And of course, the subsequent civil war that we had did not play in his favor. And more so most recently, when he had the elections which were otherwise certified by the international community that he did lose, I think the writing was on the wall and the rest is history. So I think for all the intentions of the French taking part in this equation and supporting Mr. Ouattara and getting involved in the politics, I think it's for the right reasons and it's to send a signal to Mr. Gbagbo.
The new president now, he has French military backing, okay? I mean, he has a free hand right now, doesn't he? Again, you know, this whole neocolonialism card is in play. You can only lead a country when you have powerful Western backers. And what does he have to give up to keep that support?
Well, what is the price? He who pays the piper calls the tune. Absolutely spot on. But I think the intervention is wrong. I personally think that Mr. Ouattara has his work cut out because he's got to find a mechanism to support the entire country and for the country to start operating as one. And how he galvanizes the people in the south, how he galvanizes the youths and offer employment, training, and start to identify with their aspirational needs remains to be seen whether he's capable of doing so. And he's going to need all the support he can have internationally, and very much so from the French and the international community. Otherwise, what you will find over time is that you will have a tiny rebellion again, starting in the south, building up to ouster him in the future. So to avoid that, I think the international community, the French, have got to support Mr. Ouattara. He clearly is the man of the flavor and the season at the moment. But above and beyond that, Mr. Ouattara has to find a mechanism as to how we can unite the country, how we can disarm the thousands of ammunitions out there, lots of people who have guns. How are you going to make
one of the things in researching this program, I found it remarkable how many times internationally recognized president, okay, as if it was the outside community, and we all know what the international community means. It means Western Europe and the United States. That's the international community when we hear about public opinion. And it was almost as if there was a drumbeat here, is that the West had already determined what the outcome was going to be in Ivory Coast, and then they found finally their tool to do it, and then their favorite one is military intervention. Am I wrong about that?
Yes, to an extent, it's the mindset. This is a battle of hearts and minds, and the West has got to understand that if they go in premature, if they go into countries and get involved into politics that they do not understand, if they fail to understand cultural and tribal mixes and how that integrates on the ground itself, then you can find that they can have similar situations what we find in Afghanistan, Iraq, and most recently that of Somalia. And of course, now we're seeing similar situations with Libya. So it's a lack of preparation, lack of foresight, and a lack of understanding, and very much so, they can get it so wrong, and they do not seem to be learning from the lessons. But I think the United States has learned, because this is why in Libya especially, they've decided not to take the moral high ground and push the campaign forward as they usually do in other campaigns, but taking a back seat, because mistakes can happen, and the longer that these conflicts go on, the longer that you do not find a solution to some of these crises, the more likely you can make mistakes, and the more likely public opinion can change on you. And very much this battle is hearts and minds, how you maintain the status quo locally with the population, how you maintain the coalition itself, and very much so how you maintain international consensus. And the minute that starts to change, then the whole thing starts unraveling. And there are risks when you get into these sort of mindsets and when you get involved in other people's machinery and wars. So thankfully, in this particular incident in Ivory Coast or Côte d'Ivoire, we do not find that to be the situation.